Montreal. And we'd like to present our 1992 entry into the SAE Aero Design Competition, the C-1B Foam Falcon. The C-1B is designed as a cargo aircraft to lift a maximum payload of 26 pounds. We are predicting 24 for the purposes of flying as the rules state that there's an offset for the points. The aircraft is designed to lift the weight using high lift devices, reduce drag, and performance from the engine that should give us the design requirements. The control surfaces that will be used to achieve the correct flight parameters are we have a full moving stabilator in the back, conventional rudder, and slot lift spoilerons, as you'll see later when I present to you the wing section. The aircraft is streamlined everywhere to reduce as much rolling friction as possible. You can see that the interface between the engine, the fuselage, the wing junctions, the fillets are all incorporated to try and reduce as much skin friction, profile, form, drag as possible.
Also, the design calculations were all estimated at takeoff conditions. And this is where the competition will be, is if you can get airborne. So that's all of the design was based around takeoff conditions.
So the effort was made to roll down the runway, reducing drag, reducing the angle of attack to get as much acceleration as possible, and then the point a maximum velocity, we would rotate the aircraft, drop the flaps, and lift off. At this point, we would like to present a short promotional video of the C-1B, and it shows the first test flight of the aircraft, and it shows how the aircraft flew stably and took off in a very short distance, and was able to land with very good absorbing characteristics. So following the first flight test of the aircraft, test pilot felt that a larger rudder was needed to achieve better directional control. This was subsequently added to the design, and the rudder was enlarged. Also, the prop size was varied in order to achieve maximum acceleration and optimize the aircraft during the takeoff roll. Other than this, the team felt that the aircraft performed very well and that it should, barring anything, it should achieve its design parameters. I'll get a little bit into the design of the aircraft. The main section, or the advantage of the aircraft, is the wings, which consisted of a SD7062 PT Widener section, which was modified to increase the CL max by a fixed leading edge slot and full span slotted flaps. The main section generated about 1.5 CL at 12 degrees angle of attack. And with the slots and the full span flaps, it's felt that the CL would increase to about 2.8. Also, the advantage of having slots would enable your aircraft to fly slower, maintaining a higher angle of attack, aiding in your landing speeds and reducing stress on the components. Also, the main spar went through the main section of the square. And the aerodynamics of the fuselage, it's felt that because the fuselage is basically shaped like a football, any errors that were made in coming to the figure of 2.8 for the CL would be offset by the fact that the bottom of the fuselage is flat, so it would compensate this, so it would generate a net positive lift. The methods of construction will now be dealt with by Greg.
The construction was centered around one main solid component, the spar. The spar was designed using composites. We have an end grain balsa shear web with carbon fiber top and bottom tension and compression members. The whole landing gear system is attached to the main spar. So you only need one strong member to reduce weight. The fuselage is also all composites. It's a Kevlar impregnated with epoxy. We selected Kevlar as opposed to carbon fiber because of its higher capacity to absorb impact, whereas the carbon fiber would shear. The Kevlar is much tougher. The boom is also a carbon fiber tube, which is laid up on a neon light bulb, which is also very lightweight and high strength. The wing features a very high quality epoxy glass shell or skin with a foam core. This produces a light structure and also high strength. The landing gear, can you describe?
The landing gear was realized through subsequent prior competitions that this was a main problem for aircraft because a lot of them were coming in very laden, very heavy, and they damaged landing gear on landing. And if they didn't damage it on landing, they didn't take off because of steerability. It's a very sensitive thing.
So they experienced gear bounce.
Yes, there were many bouncing problems. We realized early on that we had to design a landing gear that would track straight and would also absorb the landing shock without retransmitting it or damaging any other components. It was based on a medical syringe, which is this here, and it's sealed by a set screw. Okay. Also, closed cell polyurethane foam was added to the chamber to further increase the damping. This was as a result of a test that were done. This is a guide rod that ensures alignment of the gear, so it doesn't vary either way, as you can see from here. Also, a 2-degree offset toe-in angle was added to further increase the tracking ability of the aircraft. 4 nylon bolts bolt the landing gear to the main spar. The reason that they're nylon is so that if anything fails in the design, it should be the nylon bolts, not the spar, not the gear, not the wing. What would happen was the gear would shoot through the wing, we would repair a whole top and bottom, and away we go with a new aircraft. Also, ball bearings in the gear reduce friction. The wheel is plastic to reduce any deformation of rolling friction, and it has a black O-ring such that the aircraft will not slide in the crosswind, it will track straight. We now have drop tests that were done on the landing gear to ensure that it would handle and absorb the loads. This is approximately 23 pounds of weight, and you can see that there's not much bounce, and all of the load is absorbed within the gear, and it flexes without breaking. It's made of carbon fiber, there's a wood dowel inside, the guide rod is aluminum, and the wheels are plastic with the rubber O-ring.
And the axles are in spring steel.
The axles are spring steel, bent 90 degrees, and they go into the wheel. Okay. Also, winglets were added to the aircraft. Winglets were added to the aircraft to increase the span effectively, without increasing it actually because of the design, the competition rules. So it is felt we used Horner wingtips that turned down because it was realized that as wingtip vortices circle up from underneath and over the wingtip, instead of having wingtips that go up, which stop the vortices at this point, we decided to have them going down to stop them at the earliest possible point and dissipate them. Also, struts were added to the gear to reduce wheel strut fairings were added to reduce the drag on the aircraft. In conclusion, we'd like to say that in the final stages of the flight testing, which occurred this afternoon, the aircraft suffered an acute case of rapid deceleration sickness and is no longer with us, unfortunately. So we will never actually get to find out if it could have lifted its design goals, but we feel that it could. Thank you.
All right. Okay, well,
so we have a final shot.
Recording.